It's 1017 The Beach, Fredo live on the radio. We got a couple fellas in the building. War by the Shore this weekend going on. What's up, fellas? Yeah. We got JR, we got Angelo, a.k.a. Killing Them, Henry, right? Paco, Pac-Man, Rivera, welcome to the show. JR, real quick, and Angelo, fill me in on this night, obviously this weekend. Like I mentioned earlier to you guys off air, I was using the restroom, and I looked down, and there's War by the Shore flyer right on the floor. I'm like, man, these flyers are everywhere. Everywhere. What I was doing in the bathroom was a different story, but you guys are doing a great job promoting the fight, promoting the night. Fill me in on what's happening that night. Go ahead.
Pretty much it's an event, the Embassy Suites, first time they're right in this area. First sanctioned MMA bouts in Monterey Peninsula ever.
Sanctioned, I like that. Yeah. See, because we see a lot of fights out there, they're not sanctioned.
Yeah.
And I applaud you for that. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's been like some circus acts. I've seen a couple of people attempt to do it. And
some backyard fights. Yeah. I think Dj Neato does that, and we'll talk to Neato about that later.
Yeah, Neato with the Spider-Man pull-ups right now.
Right? Talk to me about the night. It's family-oriented. Yeah, yeah. It's like a mini festival going on.
Yeah, pretty much it's going to be all ages. You know, it's going to be 12 bouts.
Wow, 12.
A lot of people from the area, pretty much they enter the tournament, the Golden Warrior Challenge.
Okay.
And the top guys in the tournament, mixed in with some guys who already have experience, are going to be competing against each other.
Okay.
So it's all weight classes. You know, guys from different backgrounds, wrestling, taekwondo, black belts, judo, jiu-jitsu, guys from Indiana, Florida, you know, San Diego, guys from all over.
Some of the local guys, go ahead and mention them, because I mean, I know JR, I know Neato. Can we get these guys in there in a fight?
Yeah.
I know those guys.
Celebrity death match. So some of the main local guys, we got Kai Johnson, you know, we've got Michael Pham, Robert Davis, Michael Ordonez, Cody Dolan, Isaac Ross, Leroy Castro represents Salinas.
Right.
You know, we got a bunch of the guys that are kind of like headlining out here that are main guys.
So you're obviously like the main promoter, and have you fought in the past? Are you currently fighting?
Yeah, I'm number one ranked middleweight.
Look at that, man. Number one. Oh, wow. Yeah. It's okay to clap. You want to fight? No. I'm cool, man.
I don't want to get beat down. You might mix me up.
I'm cool, man. I like my face.
You know how to use both your hands at the same time, you know, different ways. You might get me with the one and two skills. I don't know.
Real quick, to that person that doesn't know, you know, about MMA fights or all these sanctioned fights, paint a picture to them, like, in 30 seconds or less, how a fight goes down as far as, is there a cage involved?
You got guys that come from different masteries and skill sets, whether it be boxing, wrestling, jiu-jitsu, judo, different arts, and they're going to put whatever arts they have together that match for them to compete against the other guy who has the match.
Does hair pulling count? Because that's the only thing that I know.
No hair pulling.
Man.
Yeah, and they all have to follow one general set base of rules.
Right.
But the whole goal is to win. You can win by points. You can win by finishes, whether it be TKO, which is a guy not being able to defend himself.
Right.
Or you can just completely knock him out.
Most importantly, you don't want to tap out.
Yeah, you don't want to
tap out. Tap out, you're done.
That's pride. That's pride.
That's pride, right?
But pretty much, you know, it works for itself. It's a way to outlet. It's a different source of time. It's a way to use your time. It's a way to attack. The reason why we call War by the Shore is because we're at war with conflict. We're
Got
at war
it.
With prejudice. We're at
right.
war with bullying.
Right.
You know, this is basically a way to address the idle time, idle minds.
And do it safe.
Exactly.
And by the shore in beautiful Monterey. You can't get better than that, right?
It doesn't get better.
Wow.
I feel like Monterey has the potential to be Cancun.
Yes. It's okay to clap. It's okay to clap. Yeah. With that said, let's introduce Paco Pac-Man Rivera, man.
Yeah,
welcome
the
to the show.
Yeah.
Is that how you start, you know, your night? You're about to get into the octagon. How do you start your night? You get pumped up. You pump yourself. Yeah.
Yeah, I pump myself. I hit myself in the body, the head, a couple of headshots. I have Angelo hitting.
Well, you know, no one can see that right now, but they can hear you. Can we get one of these? Like, right?
Boom.
Right in the face? Oh, no. Come on, man. Let's get one in the face right now. Let's hear it.
I'm not trying to be sleeping right now.
So you ranked right now. What's your situation?
I'm working towards that.
Okay.
This is something I got into about last year in Angelo, growing up with him, my
right.
brother. Man, he got me into it and inspires me, motivates me. And
now you're here. You're about to fight Saturday.
And I'm loving it.
So explain this to me. A year ago, what's your full-time job?
Full-time job.
Well, what were you doing a year ago?
Okay. This started off, I was in Colorado. I was a blackjack dealer.
Okay.
Went from doing that.
Blackjack dealer.
I never seen myself.
I want to know what was going in your head. What clicked and said,
I don't
ding,
even
ding,
know.
Ding, 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 ding. I want to get my ass kicked in the octagon.
My dream started way back, I'll say about 3 years ago.
Okay.
I had a friend, Drew Tamiano, and we always get with each other spiritually, sharing Bible verses and stuff. And he told me he had a dream that he seen me walking into the octagon, getting ready for a fight.
Look at that.
And him and Neato were together, and then all of a sudden, I was about to get ready for my fight, and
okay.
he woke up.
Well, and I applaud you for that, but I want to know, are you kicking some ass this weekend? That's what I want to know. Who are you fighting?
Oh, I'm not fighting this weekend.
You're not? What the? Hey, Neato, I need you real quick this Saturday to fight. Can you fill in?
Hey, I'll be working security. I'll be there.
Okay, you'll be working. But you're on your way to fighting.
I am.
So in future, War by the Shore.
Paco's on a three-fight knockout streak right now. We're trying to take
Wow! So now that I have you back, Angelo, real quick, you know, people have mixed feelings about MMA fight. You know, obviously, it's crazy. It looks scary. I'm looking at a TV. I'm like, damn. Wow.
The way I see it is you can injure yourself walking out of a business.
Right.
One day, you know?
I hear you.
I think whatever life has for you and whatever destiny for you is already set and predetermined.
And the only reason why I bring it up, because I'm a big boxing fan. I grew up with boxing, you know. I have mixed feelings about MMA. It's exciting. I love it. It's out there. The energy, the show, and there's money involved. But there's that mixed feeling. As far as being safe, and I hear that it's safer than boxing too sometimes.
Exactly, because it's not all targeted in one direction.
Right.
But the way I see it is basically it comes down to how well your camp trains you. See, a lot of guys have the wrong representation based on
okay.
a lot of other promotions where they're saying, like, you know, bloody beatings and things like
right.
that. You know, it's taking away the integrity of the sport when the sport's really on the art.
There was a key word you said, the art right there. There's an art to it.
Yeah, exactly.
There's an art to MMA fighting with all those combination of fighting.
Exactly. People don't always see what the fighter sees inside. Like, whereas you see two guys slugging punches, one guy's looking at a direct point to where he can attack somebody. The guy's looking for defense. His stance, everything comes down to even as critical as the way he breathes.
And that's what I, you know, there's people that, and I'll be the first one to admit it. I'll watch it on TV. I'm like, man, I'm like that guy on Friday. He got knocked up. Ow! You know? And I'm feeling for that person.
Yeah.
But that person, he knew what he was signed up for. With that said, obviously this night is, you know, family night. There's going to be young youth there.
Yeah, all ages.
What do you have to say to them that, you know, might be interested in someday, you know, being involved in MMA fighting and someday getting into a cage?
What I'll pretty much say is there's more jobs than just actually fighting within this organization. You know, you could be a manager. You could
right.
be a trainer.
You could be a trainer. Fighter, you could be the water guy. What does Neato do? I want to know what Neato does.
Neato's on the ones and twos.
He's on the ones and twos.
He's the heart of this whole fight. He basically, the way you feel, there you go. The way you feel about this is pretty much it comes down to how Neato spins on
the let's get Neato on the mic. By the way, let's bring the mic down because Neato.
It is with me. Yeah. Turn down the left, bro. Yeah.
Let's put your stats in there. How tall are you?
I'm
5'2". 5'2", let's see, 100.
I'm 5'2", but check this out.
So Neato's involvement at War by the Shore, he's obviously playing the music for the guys to get pumped up, for the crowd to get pumped up.
Yep.
Pretty much all that. Neato, what are you playing for some of these guys? Have they put the playlist in?
I'm going to go just with the
feel. Okay.
I'm going to go with the environment is. Pumped up.
Well, let me get JR back on here. JR, War by the Shore, give me all the details this weekend. Go ahead.
November 22nd, that's on a Saturday, right off the freeway. Doors open at 5, first fight's at 7. We're going to have, like you said, DJ, booths, a lot of good representation, food, alcohol, anything. Obviously, you have to be 21. But most importantly...
Wait, you said alcohol? I'm there. Wow.
Well, that's so why. I knew you were here, Fredo, so I had to say alcohol because I want you to show
yes.
up.
Yes. You know what I mean? Yeah, and most important, a lot of ass whoopings.
That's true. That's
safe, right. In a safe way.
It's going to be a big, long night of fights, and basically the message to the kids that I wanted to emphasize.
Go ahead.
You know, basically this is a place to get everything out, idle time, idle minds, but we're addressing unity in the community. Stop all the gang violence.
Yes,
stop
thank you. Yeah. Round of applause. And with that, no, man, once again, I want to thank you guys for being here, and we'll definitely see you Saturday.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Yeah.